Thank you, Ellen. If you have your Bibles with you this morning, I'm going to be reading from the book of Genesis this morning, chapter 9. Stand with me as we read from God's Word. Genesis chapter 9. We'll begin reading at verse 8, at what I'm sure will be familiar scripture to you. And God spoke unto Noah and to his sons with him, saying, And I, behold, I establish my covenant with you, and with your seed after you, with every living creature that is with you, of the fowl, of the cattle, and of every beast of the earth with you, from all that go out of the ark to every beast of the earth. And I will establish my covenant with you, neither shall all flesh be cut off any more by the waters of a flood, neither shall there any more be a flood to destroy the earth. And God said, This is the token of the covenant which I have made between me and you, and every living creature that is with you, for perpetual generations. I do set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be for a token of a covenant between me and the earth. And it shall come to pass when I bring a cloud over the earth, that the bow shall be seen in the cloud. And I will remember my covenant which is between me and you, and every living creature of all flesh, and the waters shall no more become a flood to destroy all flesh. And the bow shall be in the cloud. And I will look upon it, that I may remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, This is the token of the covenant which I have established between me and all flesh that is upon the earth. May God add his blessing to the reading of his word. Let's bow our heads for a moment. We're grateful this morning, Lord, for your word, and we pray that you may speak to us through it and from it. And for that, we will thank you. Amen. You may be seated. When Noah and his family emerged from the ark after the flood, God established a covenant with Noah, promising never again to flood the entire earth. This was a covenant that promised to preserve man and every living creature. Never again, God promised, would he flood the entire earth. And as a token of that covenant, God said in verse 13, I do set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be for a token or for a sign or a memorial of a covenant between me and the earth. God actually said in verse 15 and 16 that when he saw the rainbow, it would serve to remind him of this covenant. Now, don't think that God needed that to keep him from forgetting. God never forgets anything. So don't ever be concerned that he will forget you. But the rainbow, after it rains, was to serve as both a reminder to both God and man that there never again would be a worldwide flood. It serves as a memorial to that covenant to this very day. I don't know about you, but I get a good feeling every time I see a rainbow. Coming down out of the mountains of Colorado onto the plains on the last elk hunt I was able to go on, we saw a spectacular rainbow. I'd never seen one like it before. You could see the entire rainbow because you could see for 10 or 15 miles in both directions of the storm. And the sun was shining on both sides of that storm, and the rainbow looked like the arch in St. Louis. I'd never seen one like that before, but it was gorgeous. Yes, rainbows are beautiful, but I don't get a good feeling from the beauty of the rainbow alone. I get it from knowing that my God in heaven is still alive, still well, still watching over me, mm-hmm. watching over his earth.
Amen.
And it also reminds me, and it ought to remind you, that God keeps his promises. 4,000 years or so have passed since God made this promise, and the world hasn't flooded again yet. And the rainbow says it won't.
Amen.
So a rainbow serves as a memorial as well as a reminder. And when I see one, it should cause me to remember what it was all about. And I don't know about you, but my practice is that whenever I see one, I purposely remind myself of what's behind it. Of course, if you don't accept the Genesis account of creation, the flood, and all that stuff, then a rainbow is nothing to you but a nice-looking part of nature. Nothing more. But to those of us who believe there's a God in heaven, that says for sure,
amen,
our God is there and still watching over us. What do you think each year, or think of each year, when Memorial Day rolls around? Remember, like the rainbow, Memorial Day's purpose is to cause us to remember something. It was a day set aside for us to commemorate or remember all our dead servicemen and women who died in the service of their country. But for many today, they never think of this. That's why they need reminded. I would have loved to seen if O'Reilly would have sent Waters out to do Waters World this weekend. Maybe he did and I didn't see it. Did he?
Yes.
Some of you say, did he get the same kind of stupid answers he gets from everything else?
Worse.
Yeah. But people don't have a clue of what Memorial Day is all about. To many, Memorial Day causes them to think about summer vacation, backyard barbecues, family get-togethers. But beyond that, they don't have a clue. Nothing else. How sad. In many churches, Memorial Day is all but ignored because it is not a holy day on the church calendar. And some churches and pastors also ignore it because they're very anti-military. By now you know I am not one of those.
Amen.
I believe it is very important for us in the church to remember. For if it had not been for the brave men and women who gave their lives in defense of our country and freedom, we literally might not be in this church this morning worshiping our God.
Amen.
The way we choose. The ability to remember is a wonderful gift that God has given us. Because of memory, think about it, you can relive your wedding day. You can relive that moment that big buck fell to your gun. You can relive our children, your children. And even if they're this high, you can remember what they were like when they were little babies, aged down here. Some of our memories are happy, as we recall wonderful experiences. Others are sad, and we weep as we think of them. But thank God for memory. Memories are also very practical. If you couldn't remember when you're driving your car that a red light means stop, you probably wouldn't live very long. You might even be in for bigger trouble than that if you can't remember your wedding anniversary. But we're in for bigger trouble as a nation if and when we don't remember what Memorial Day stands for. When I was a kid, Memorial Day was known as Decoration Day. In our neck of the woods, I guess it was in your neck of the woods here too, so many of you are shaking your heads. That was the time of year that people would put flowers on the graves of departed loved ones, whether they were soldiers or not. How many of you remember Decoration Day? Quite a few of you do. You can tell how old you are, or how old you're not. We not only choose to remember our military today, but as you already saw, we've made this Sunday a day here at our church where we remember those from our congregation that have died since last year at Memorial Day as well. Thank God we only had to remember one today. I like that practice because people have a tendency to forget, even when it comes to death. People have a tendency to forget. And if you don't think people tend to forget, just think of how many who even call themselves Christians seem to have forgotten today is Sunday, the Lord's Day. And they'll be doing anything but being in God's house. Surely they ought to know better. A few years ago, a young and successful executive was traveling down a Chicago neighborhood street. He was going a bit fast in his sleek black Jaguar 12-cylinder XKE, which was only 2 months old. He was watching carefully for kids darting out from between parked cars, and he slowed down when he thought he saw something. As his car passed a certain spot, no child darted out, but a brick flew out, and whoop! It slammed into the Jag's shiny black door. He slammed on the brakes and his gears ground in reverse. Tires spinning, the Jag back to the spot where the brick had been thrown. He jumped out of the car, grabbed the kid that was still standing there, and pushed him up against the car. He shouted, "Who are you? And what do you think you're doing?" Building up a head of steam, he went on, "That's my new Jag. And the brick you threw is going to cost you a lot of money. Why did you throw it?" "Please, mister, please, I'm sorry. I didn't know what else to do. I threw the brick because no one else would stop." Tears were dripping down the boy's chin as he pointed around the parked car. He said, "It's my brother, mister. He rolled off the curb and fell out of his wheelchair, and I can't lift him up." Huh? Sobbing, The little boy pled, "Would you please help me get him back in his wheelchair? He's hurt. He's too heavy for me." Moved beyond words, the young executive tried desperately to swallow the rapidly swelling lump in his throat. Straining, he lifted the young man back into his wheelchair. He took out his handkerchief. He wiped the scrapes and cuts, checking to see if everything else was okay. He then walked with that little boy to make sure that he was able to get his brother back to his house all right. But it was a long walk back to his sleek, black, shining 12-cylinder Jaguar XKE. A long, slow walk. True story. He never did fix the side door. He kept the dent to remind himself not to go through life so fast that someone has to throw a brick at him to get his attention.
Amen.
Yep.
Whatever you need to do to keep you reminded of the important stuff in life, my friend, do it. Even if it means not fixing the car. If it will remind you of the important stuff in life, do it. Now, hopefully nobody will have to throw a brick at you this morning to get your attention. I think I'm speaking to a crowd this morning that pretty much knows what Memorial Day is all about. Pretty much knows why we do it each year. And if your little one doesn't, teach them. If you don't, nobody else will. But if you cherish your freedom, at least the freedom that we still have left, and in case you haven't noticed, your freedoms are disappearing very quickly. But if you cherish what freedom we still have left, thank a serviceman or woman today. Shake their hands and tell them thanks and shock them. I saw a guy a while back. He must have just came back from Afghanistan. He still had his uniform on, what have you. He couldn't have been home very long. When I saw him, I simply reached out and said, "Thank you, buddy." He was looking all forlorn, but when I said, "Thank you," and shook his hand, he perked up. Many of our servicemen and women, remember Vietnam? Chuck remembers Vietnam. Served his country, only to come home and be spit on. If you cherish your freedom, you run into one today, thank a serviceman or a servicewoman. No matter if they were a cook or a typist or what they were. They served their country. They served their country.
Amen.
And hopefully when you see God's rainbow in the sky, it will serve to remind you that our God keeps his promises. And hopefully nobody will need to throw a rock at you to get your attention to remind you of your need for Christ. But if they do, if somewhere along the line somebody does throw a rock at you and it reminds you about your need for Christ, I hope you will keep that brick. You let it serve as a reminder that God loves you, and somebody else loved you enough to remind you of that fact. On this Memorial Day weekend, may we be thankful for all those who have served, and especially for those who gave their lives, so again, we are free to worship here this morning. We want to honor all our servicemen and women who may be present this morning, as we always do. Before we have those that serve came forward, I want to ask if there's anyone present that lost a member of their family in the military in the service of their country. We would be honored to have you come forward first to represent your loved one. If you had a loved one who died in World War II, Korea, Vietnam, wherever, we'd be honored to have you come forward. Is there anyone like that? Come forward at this time if there is. I believe you're the only one this morning, Joan.
Yeah.
And who are you representing?
My brother, Ira Shore.
Your brother.
He's killed in Korea.
God bless his memory.
Yes.
Now we'd like to have all our servicemen and women who are present here this morning who served in any way at any time. Doesn't matter if you served in a war, you served in peacetime, you served. Doesn't matter if you ever held a gun, if you ever shot anybody. Like I said, maybe you were a cook. Armies need cooks, just like they need generals. Anybody else? Waiting for Bill to get up here. The war's loading down.
My wife.
Your wife did
that. Well, it's a war anyway.
We're proud. We're allowed to be proud. Some things you are allowed to be proud of. We're proud to have this group here this morning representing our church. Give them all a hand, will you? God bless you, fellas. Appreciate y'all. And young. Appreciate the memory of your brother. Now you guys can stand here if you can see it, or you can sit right down on the front seat. We're going to watch a video in closing at this time, so Wayne will take care of that. Titled American Soldier. No better soldier in the world. Oh, I know there have been atrocities here and there. There always are in wars. But these are the only soldiers probably in the history of the world that pick up little children, that will help the enemy, that won't come over and shoot somebody that's already been shot. Thank God for American soldiers, whoever they are. Whenever you're ready, Waylon, to watch it.
I'm just trying to be a father, raise a daughter and a son. Be a lover to their mother, everything to everyone. Up and out on bright and early, my business in my suit. Yeah, I'm dressed up for success, from my head down to my boots. I don't do it for the money, there's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory, I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures, my responsibility. Yeah, I'm real good under pressure, being all that I can be. I can't call in sick on Mondays when the weekend's been too strong. I just work straight through the holidays, sometimes all night long. You can bet that I stand ready when the wolf growls at the door. Hey, I'm solid, hey, I'm steady, hey, I'm true down to the core. And I will always do my duty, no matter what the price. I've counted up the cost.